donate.
My beloved brothers and sisters, we need to be more conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to develop a better relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, as the days and the years are passing, we are getting closer and closer to the day we are going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a winner is the one who looks at age and the years passing as time that is making us become closer to the day we're going to return to Allah. So therefore, develop a better relationship with Allah as the days pass. And don't turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, today is the 13th of March 2020. So you and I know that across the globe, there is a scare. The scare of something that cannot be seen by the naked eye. The scare of a germ, a virus that is actually contaminating so much and it is spreading faster than a wild fire. My brothers and sisters, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, taught us years ago, centuries ago, about everything. مَا تَرَكَ خَيْرًا إِلَّا وَدَلَّنَا عَلَيْهِ وَلَا شَرًّا إِلَّا حَذَّرَنَا مِنْهُ. No goodness except the Prophet Muhammad taught us about it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No evil, no harm except that he mentioned it, he taught us about it. Number one, he taught us about cleanliness and about making sure that we are always clean. If you look at the ablution or the wudu that we are supposed to be engaging in before we pray, it entails washing your hands thoroughly 5 times a day in such a way that the middle of your fingers and the bottom of your nails are supposed to be washed. It teaches us about the toes and how to wash the middle of your toes, how to wash your face, your hands, and so on. Keep yourself extremely clean. He has taught us about how to wash up after using the bathroom. And this is something that we should not be ashamed of. It is actually such a beautiful teaching, if only we knew and if only we understood. So cleanliness is something that is very, very important in Islam, to the degree that the Prophet ﷺ says, "At-tuhuru shatrul iman." Your cleanliness is half of your faith. So much of importance given to it. And obviously, when we speak of cleanliness, the first thing that comes to the mind is the cleanliness that is physical, to do with your water, to do with your bathing, to do with, you know, cleaning yourself, ensuring you're presentable, looking neat, etc. But it also includes cleaning your thoughts, cleaning your dealings, and cleaning everything else, your social living and so on. All of that is included. But there is another thing that the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, taught us. He said that if you hear of a plague in a certain land, don't go there. And if you are in a place where the plague is, there is an outbreak, then don't exit from it. In fact, in the narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks about how a person who knows that his suburb has been affected by a plague and decides to leave it, running away from it, he is like a person who ran away from a war zone when he was supposed to defend his own nation. So he says, you don't run away. The reason is, you won't be able to tell if you are affected or contaminated. And if you don't know, chances are, there is a possibility that you are. And if you were, you would be carrying it to other places. So this whole concept of quarantine is actually from the Sunnah and the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, more than 1400 years back, when he says, if you're affected, you don't leave and you don't let anyone come in. Amazing. My brothers, my sisters, we know that the world has become a global village. We know that because of communication and transport at a very advanced stage, this virus has flown from the east to the west, from the north to the south. There were people at the beginning saying that perhaps it's a hoax, maybe it is nothing serious, perhaps it is something that people don't need to worry about, it's just an ordinary flu. All that in its place. The reality is, it is spreading, people are dying. Let's look at what's happening on the ground. Huge nations have decided no more flights coming in or out from many countries of the globe. People are in quarantine. Not just ordinary people on the streets, but no matter who you are. My brothers and sisters, it's your duty to take it seriously. Thank Allah that today we are seated here in this masjid for Salatul Jum'ah. Thank Allah. Alhamdulillah ala dhalik. Do you know that there are places that have stopped the salah in the masjid simply because of contamination from the masajid and contamination from places of worship? Now one might say, I'm a Muslim, I'm taught to read the dua, Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma'asmihi shay'un fil ardi wala fis samai wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. The meaning of which is, I am taking the name of Allah, in the name of Allah, with whose name nothing in the skies or on earth can harm at all. Nothing's going to harm me. He is indeed the all-hearing, the all-knowing. So they say, once I say this prayer three times, which by the way is a sunnah, you must say the prayer. It is important to say that dua and many other duas. But that does not mean that you don't do what is known by as al-akhd bil-asbab. You need to make sure you have taken heed the means that you have to avoid contamination and to avoid being affected and to avoid this from spreading. You need to make sure that you have taken every precaution. So some Muslims say, if I have said the dua, it's okay. I can go for Jum'ah, I can go for Jama'ah, I can go for anything else because that is a sunnah or that is a teaching of Islam, etc. Not realizing if you are unwell, it is haram to go at a time like this when you know you could be affected by the virus and affect so many others. Totally forbidden. How could I ever knowingly go to a public place and I know there is a plague around and I know that the symptoms are XYZ, or I know I've been to a zone where it was a red zone and there are so many cases there, and I think tawakkaltu ala Allah, I'm going. A'udhu billah. You cannot do that. My brothers and sisters, take it seriously. If the health inspectors or whichever department is responsible decides that, you know what, there will be no more public gatherings for any reason because of this virus, they are justified. Did you hear what I said? We have to say from the pulpit, they are justified because they are trying to contain the outbreak. They are trying to contain it from getting worse. You have to understand, if there is no Jumu'ah next week, we will do Salat al-Dhuhr at home. And we will thank Allah that at least we're okay. So it's not like you have to come even if you're sick or ill. I know of a brother, very sick, and he says, no, that is Jumu'ah, I have to go. It's my duty as a Muslim, my brother. When you are sick, you don't even need to fast. When you are sick and ill, you don't even need to go for Hajj. When you know you are unwell, it's not like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do certain things knowing that you are unwell. So let's not fool ourselves. Let's not fool ourselves. If you are unwell, participate in what is known as self-quarantine, which means you make sure you don't mix with others, you make sure you have your mask, you make sure you clean, you make sure you let those around you know that, look, because I'm not well, I would like to keep a bit of a distance, and thereafter make sure you get yourself tested. And now comes the big one. May Allah protect all of us. Say Ameen. If you are tested positive, you may suffer financial loss, you may suffer various other loss. All those losses are okay. Don't worry. The financial loss is never ever bigger than the protection of humanity. Remember that. Many of us have planned holidays, we've planned meetings, we've planned travels, we've planned journeys that may not happen. Some of us in our businesses, our companies, we will lose a lot of money. It's okay. Ride the wave. For now is the time to take this seriously. Very seriously. Make sure, you know, when we greet each other, the sunnah is to greet. Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam. We don't have to shake hands, especially when it comes to some a time of this sort, where you know there could be contamination. And as clean as you think you are, it just requires a small contamination for you to be affected before you know your entire family to be affected and so many others to be affected just because you thought, I must shake hands because I really want to fulfill, I must hug. Hug. Is the hug farad? Is it compulsory? The answer is no. So at a time like this, even if I just greeted you or you greeted each other with the greeting of a hand from a distance, it is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Get used to it for a while. To put on a mask or to put something on is not wrong. Subhanallah. In fact, you would have to at a certain point. We are fortunate in this particular city. It's not that bad, but who knows how bad it is. It takes a few days before you can actually figure out what has happened. So I've chosen to speak about this today because from the pulpit of the Friday, it's important that we educate our people. There may come a day when authorities decide we will not be able to gather in large gatherings for whatever purpose it is. That day might come very soon. It has already happened in other countries. People started asking, is it permissible for them to say you cannot gather for Jumu'ah? I promise you, my brothers and sisters, if there is a plague of this nature and there is a darura, there is a need, it is definitely permissible for them to impose on us that we're not allowed to gather. The idea is to save humanity. Remember this, it's not a personal thing. And your iman does not negate the fact that you have to stay away and you have to protect yourself. Like I say, some people think I'm a Muslim, I read Quran every day, I make my dua every day, nothing will affect me. My brothers and sisters, don't fool yourself. Don't fool yourself. There are people who read Quran and Salah and they make their dua. They have still been affected and some have even died of diseases, be it this one or another one. So don't fool yourself. Don't think, you know what, I'm a pious man. I have not missed my Salah in the first Saf. So how can I miss it now? I haven't missed, you know, something all my life. How can I miss it now? I promise you the reward for protecting humanity is greater than the reward for your individual acts of worship. Remember that. The reward for protecting humanity is greater than the reward of your individual acts. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all goodness and ease. And remember, everything is in the hands of Allah. Let's pray that Allah protect us. Let's pray for those who are affected that Allah grant them cure. It is a serious matter. Don't be excited when you hear that country is affected, this country is affected. Don't ever be excited because it's a matter of time before it comes to you and I. Similarly, my brothers and sisters, sleep well. Sleep well. Do you know why? If you would like your immune system to be strengthened, put your phone away and go to bed. Those who have a sound sleep at night have a better immune system than those who have not had proper sleep. So sleep well. Eat healthy. Make sure that you're having your vitamins and minerals. Make sure that you're fit. Make sure that you have boosted your immune system somehow. Because together with making dua to Allah and praying to Him, you and I need to make sure that we have done something within our capacity to save ourselves. Similarly, never ever become people who do what is known as panic buying. What is panic buying? Which means, oh, there might be a lockdown in 2 weeks, so let me go and buy 2 tons of baked beans because I love baked beans. So everyone goes, instead of buying 1 tin or 2 tins, they buy 10 cases and they want to bring it back. And before you know it, there is nothing left for anyone, subhanAllah. Don't do panic buying. Things will be okay by the will of Allah. Things will be okay by the will of Allah. Also, Let us never ever discriminate based on race, simply because we heard that this outbreak could have started maybe in China. People look at anyone who looks like a Chinese and maltreat them, literally, unacceptably treat them in a way that is tantamount to a crime against humanity. That's unfair. That is un-Islamic. It is uncalled for. It is wrong. It doesn't mean that anyone who looks this way suddenly has the virus. That's not true. The person doing this type of discrimination could be the one who's the carrier. Who knows? And he's laughing at others. That's why they say, لَا تَطْهَرِ الشَّمَاتَةَ لِأَخِيكَ فَيَرْحَمُهُ اللَّهُ وَيَبْتَلِيكَ. Don't ever show excitement when someone else is inflicted or affected with negativity, because perhaps Allah might have mercy on them, cure them, give them goodness, and you know what? He might test you with the same. So my brothers and sisters, let's learn to be caring for one another. At this juncture, humanity is struggling. This virus knows no faith, no race, no nationality. It is traveling the globe just like that. Anyone can be affected at any time, no matter how pious you are, no matter how distant you are from Allah. All of that, to a certain extent, you and I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested us. Let's learn to pass this test. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our doors and to make us from those who can reach out to the rest of humanity. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'ani wa sunnah wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihima min al-ayati wal-hikmah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisairil muslimina fastaghfiru.